The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a virgin, and the name of the virgin was Mary. Upon arriving, the angel said to her, "Rejoice, O highly favored daughter, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." When she heard him, she was troubled at his word and kept wondering what manner of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found grace with God. Behold, you shall conceive in your womb and shall bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great and shall be called the Son of the Most High, and his kingdom will have no end." But Mary said, "How can this be when I am a virgin? The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you, and therefore the child to be born will be called the Son of God. Behold, your cousin Elizabeth, who is barren and at her old age, had also conceived a child. She is 6 months pregnant, for nothing is impossible with God. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word." And the angel departed from her. Mary went into the hill country and entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary, the baby in her womb leaped with joy. She was filled with the Holy Spirit and cried out in a loud voice, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb." He said to Mary, "Why is it that the mother of my Lord will come to me?" Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. Behold, henceforth all generations shall call me blessed, for he has done great and mighty things to his lowly servant, and holy is his name." Mary attended to Elizabeth until she gave birth to a son, whose name was John the Baptist. It came to pass, while they were in Bethlehem, the time came for Mary to have her child. She brought forth her firstborn son. They wrapped him in a swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. There were shepherds in the same district, and the angel of the Lord stood by them. "Do not be afraid, for I bring you good news of great joy, which shall be to all the people. For today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you, who is Christ the Lord. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Behold, the Magi came from the east, and entering, they found the child with Mary his mother, and falling down, they worshipped him, and offered him gift of all frankincense and myrrh." Mary kept in mind all these things, pondering them in her heart. According to the law of Moses, they took the child Jesus to Jerusalem to be presented to the Lord. There was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. It has been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he should not see death before he had seen the Messiah of the Lord. When the parents brought in the child Jesus, he took him up in his arm and blessed God. "Master, you may now let your servant go in peace. The word has been fulfilled." And he prophesied to Mary about the child being destined to be the fall and the rise of many in Israel, and in their soul a sore shall fear. When Jesus was 12 years old, they went up to Jerusalem according to the custom of the feast. And when they were returning, the boy Jesus remained in Jerusalem without his parents knowing it. When Mary and Joseph learned that Jesus was left behind, they went back to Jerusalem and looked for Jesus. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all those who have heard him were all astounded. Mary said to her son, "Why have you done this to us? Your father and I have been looking for you with great anxiety." Jesus said, "Why were you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be at my Father's house?" And they did not understand the word that he spoke to them. And Jesus went down with them to Galilee and came to Nazareth, and was obedient to them. Jesus increased in age, wisdom, and grace before God and man. Jesus was 30 years old when he came from Galilee to Jordan to be baptized by John. John tried to dissuade him with the word, "It is I who need baptism from you, and yet you come to me." Jesus said, "Leave it like this for the time being. It is fitting that we should in this way do all that the uprightness demand." And John gave in to him. After Jesus had been baptized, he at once came out from the water, and behold, the heaven opened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon him. And a voice was heard from heaven, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." The Holy Spirit led Jesus in the wilderness. He fasted for 40 days. Satan appeared, tested Jesus 3 times. Jesus resisted all the temptation, and Satan left him for a while. On the 3rd day, there was a wedding at Cana in Galilee. The mother of Jesus was there, and Jesus and his disciples had also been invited. The wine ran out, since the wine provided for at the feast had all been used. Mary said to her son, "There is no more wine." Jesus said, "Woman, what do you want from me? My hour has not yet come." Mary said to the servant, "Do whatever he tells you." And Jesus performed his first miracle by changing water into wine, and his disciples believed in him. Seeing the crowd, Jesus went up to the mountain. He sat down, and his disciples joined him. Then he began to speak. "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs the kingdom of God. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God. And blessed are those who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness. Theirs is a kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when you are reviled and accused falsely for my sake. Be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For they so persecuted the prophets before you." Then Jesus began to teach, preach, and heal. He made wonders and miracles. He raised the dead, cast out demons, fed the hungry multitude, walked on the water, calmed the storm. Jesus took Peter, James, and John and led them to a high mountain. There in their presence, Jesus was transfigured. His face was as radiant as the sun, and his clothes as white as snow. And behold, Moses and Elijah appeared to them. They were talking with Jesus. Peter spoke to Jesus, "Lord, it is wonderful for us to be here. If you want to, I'll make 3 shelters, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He was still speaking when suddenly a bright cloud covered them with a shadow, and from the cloud a voice was heard, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Listen to him." When the disciples heard this, they fell on their face, overcome with fear. Jesus went up and touched them. "Do not be afraid, stand up." When they raised their eyes, they saw no one but Jesus. While descending from the mountain, Jesus told his disciples not to tell anyone about the vision until the Son of Man has been risen from the dead. On the night before he was given to death, he took the bread, gave thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink, eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave thanks to his disciples, to give thanks to the Lord, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood and the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins will be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." After the Last Supper, Jesus and his disciples went to the Garden of Gethsemane to pray. Jesus said to his disciples, "My soul is sorrowful even unto death. Wait here and watch." Going forward a little, he fell on the ground and began to pray. "Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me, yet not my will, but as your will." And the angel appeared and administered to him. Falling into agony, he prayed more earnestly, and he sweat like droplets of blood falling on the ground. Jesus went to his disciples and found them sleeping. "Could you not watch 1 hour with me? Watch and pray that you may not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." Judas came accompanied by soldiers and Pharisees, approached Jesus and kissed him as a sign of betrayal. Jesus was arrested, bound, they brought him before the Sanhedrin. The high priest convicted Jesus guilty of blasphemy. They brought him before Pontius Pilate. Pilate asked Jesus, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus said, "My kingdom is not from this world, yet you say I am a king. This is why I was born and came to this world, to bear witness to the truth." Pilate said, "I found no guilt with this man. I'll have him chastised and released him." And they plagued Jesus many times, almost killing him. The soldiers brought Jesus into the courtyard. They put a purple military cloak on him, twisting a crown of thorns. They put it on his head and a reed on his right hand. And they knelt down and mocked him, "Hail Jesus, King of the Jews." And they spat upon him, took the reed and kept beating him on the head. They brought Jesus back to Pilate. He made an announcement to the crowd, "I am releasing one prisoner today. Who would you like it to be, Barabbas or Jesus?" And the crowd shouted, "Release Barabbas." "What about Jesus, your king?" And the Pharisees shouted back, "We have no king but Caesar. Crucify him." Washing his hands, claiming innocence on the blood of Jesus, he gave Jesus to the crowd to be crucified. Jesus accepted the cross and walked to Calvary. He fell 3 times carrying the heavy cross. He met his afflicted mother. Simon of Cyrene helped Jesus carry the cross. Veronica wiped the face of Jesus. Jesus met the woman of Jerusalem. When they reached Mount Calvary, they stripped him of his garment and nailed his hands and feet on the cross. They lifted up the cross, hanging in agony and pain. Jesus uttered his last words, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. Amen, I say to you, today thou shalt be with me in paradise. Mother, behold thy son. Son, behold thy mother. My God, why hast thou forsaken me? I thirst. It is finished. Father, into thy hand I commend my spirit." And bowed his head and breathed his last. On the third day, Jesus resurrected from the dead. With his glorified body, he appeared to his disciples and stayed with them for 40 days, preparing them for the Great Commission. On the 48th day, Jesus instructed his disciples to stay in Jerusalem and wait for the coming of the Holy Spirit. Then Jesus led them to the Mount of Olives. There he lifted up his hands and blessed them, saying, "All powers of heaven and earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations. Baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Teach them to observe all that I have commanded you. Those who believe in me baptized will be saved, and those who do not believe will be condemned. Behold, I am with you all days, even unto the consummation of the world." Then he ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. 10 days after the day of Pentecost, the Holy Spirit descended upon the apostles like a mighty wind and fire of tongues that separated and rested on the head of each one of them. They were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak of wonderful words. There were devout Jews staying in Jerusalem from every nation under heaven. And Peter, standing with the 11, lifted up his voice and spoke to them, "Repent and be baptized, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit." Those who received his word were baptized, and about 3,000 souls were added that day. A reverent fear overtook them all, for many wonders and miracles were performed by the apostles. The time came when the Blessed Virgin Mary fell into a deep sleep and died. At the house of dormition, while the apostles were having their vigil, our Lord Jesus Christ appeared and lifted the body and soul of the Blessed Virgin Mary to heaven amidst the rejoicing of the angels. And in heaven, the Blessed Virgin Mary, the mother of the Son of God, the daughter of God the Father, and the spouse of God the Holy Spirit, was crowned Queen of Heaven and Earth, Queen of all creation, and Queen of the Most Holy Rosary. Amen.